Shalom everybody, God bless you. I'm Prophetess Shanique and I needed to come on and share this with you. I didn't plan to film or upload anything today, but hear me for a few minutes. This modern day aesthetic Christianity is foolishness. It's deception and it's a lie. No, hear me out. Many of you are prophets, many of you are pastors, many of you are, you know, just sons and daughters who are anointed and sent by God to prophetically do his will. And by doing his will, many of you will prophesy, it will come to pass. Many of you will cast out devils. Many of you will lay hands for healing and healing will be done. Now, here's the perplexing part of this is many of you who are prophesying to others that they will, you know, build houses, they will buy cars, etc. This prophetic word has come to pass, but for you, it seems like God is nowhere to be found. Many of you have casted out devils out of many, but you are still praying and asking God to deliver your family. Many of you have laid hands on the sick multiple times and they have recovered expeditiously, but you are still waiting for God to heal you of that condition. You have prayed for sick children, but you're waiting on God to heal your child and you're asking God, what have I done? What could I have done that you can use me to help these people, to heal these people, to encourage these people? But when it comes to my life, when it comes to my house, it seems like you're nowhere to be found. Many of you have seen the Lord use you so mightily, but you're wondering, when will he work and turn things around for your house? No, as I sat and I remember listening to a video several months ago, actually, and there's a prophet, a powerful man of God, that he shared that, you know, he's raised the dead before and he saw where his brother becomes sick and the Lord showed him where his brother would die and he was not giving him the authority to raise his brother from the dead. Can you imagine how it looks to raise a dead, but your brother is dying and you can't raise or bring healing to your own brother? Many people will look on from the outside and they will say that, how are you even a prophet and you can preach to all these people? You're so powerful in church, you're so powerful in the pulpit, but you can't pray for healing over your own home, you can't pray for healing over your own body. And you know, I thought about it, and as I went back and forth in contemplation, you know, asking God questions, and it's not that the questions I'm asking God I don't know, but you will understand when you begin to serve in certain capacities that there are some things you will know and there are some things you will understand, but it doesn't make it any easier for you to go through. And one of the misconceptions about someone being a prophet is that they're seen as someone who is anointed and strong, but many people do not know what they go through behind closed doors. What many of you don't understand is that while some of these prophets are prophesying and bringing healing and foretelling and, you know, pulling things out of the spiritual realm into the natural and manifesting it in your life by the power of God, they're still waiting on God to do it for them. No, I remember last year, I think it was last year, July, August, I had a vision. And what brought me to this, I had a vision last night. But last year, July, I had a vision where the enemy rose up from out of the ground. He just rose up literally out of hell. And he pulled me underneath the ground. And I was chained in something like a prison cell underneath the layers of this earth. And while he locked me in this place, he said to me that I am going to punish and torture you for what God is going to do in your life. We were just getting ready to launch the school of the prophet, the Bible school that we have. And he said to me, I'm going to punish and torture you for what you're about to do. And the Lord just began to show me, you know, everything that was happening. And he pulled me out. And one of the things that I remember is after I came out of that vision, I was sick for several months. Many people did not know this. But I remember at the point of feeling as though I wanted to give up, the Holy Spirit reminded me, remember what the enemy said, that he was going to punish you. This sickness is not unto death, but the enemy is just mad because of what I was going to do. And I remember the Lord gave me specific instructions. I did it, and you know, I was healed and I was okay. Last night I had another vision. I won't share everything in depth, but I had a vision, and at the point of almost death, I was crying to God. I was asking God, you know what, at this point, just if there be anything in my life that doesn't please you, just forgive me of my sins, take me home peacefully. I've done what I've needed to do in this earth realm. And you know, I've prayed and I've asked the Lord to help me. there was no answer, and it was when he did not answer any at all that I said, you know what, okay, fine, take me home. At the point of death, I remember I prayed, if there be any ministry left within me based on your word that you have spoken, send my angel. I had an encounter with a cherubim that came and helped me. But the thing that made me go back and question God today was, why did you allow the enemy to do what he did and then come to deliver me after? And when I thought about it, his answer to me once again was, not everybody can be trusted to suffer. Not everyone can be trusted to go through. There are some people, their testimony will be they were healed immediately. They were delivered immediately. But there are some people that have been entrusted by the Spirit of God to pay the price differently. There are some, and this is not about me, I'm just wanting to encourage somebody. There are some of you that God has chosen that you will go through some things because he has handpicked you. He has given you the grace. He's given you the endurance. He's given you the longevity. Because some of you are asking God, am I doing something wrong? People on the outside may presume or assume that there's no way you can be a child of God and you're going through what you're going through. There are some people that are not anointed enough. Some people do not have enough capacity to understand with your spiritual warfare. When I saw this thing, my first resort upon interpretation was, I will not share this thing with my mother, because the one thing that she will not do is understand. I won't share this thing with some people because they will not understand why I'd have to go through. Say, for example, God forbid, the enemy shows you where you will go through a few months of sickness or something. There's some things you can't share with everyone because they will begin to pray and they will begin to say, no, you won't go through this. You can't go through this. What's going to happen? Are you going to die? While you are going through and you're resting in peace and a surety, and you're in a place of rest knowing that God has already shown this to you and you know that you cannot die. You know, Paul says that thrice I have prayed, 1 Corinthians 12. Three times have I prayed that God will remove this thorn in the flesh, but he did not. And when he realized that God would not remove the thorn in the flesh, whatever your interpretation is that the thorn in the flesh is, whether the thorn in the flesh was a woman that he was dealing with, some theologians believe that it was the sight, he had a sight issue. There are many people that believe he had an infirmity. Whatever your interpretation is, nevertheless, Paul got to a place in his life where he learned. He said, I will be content. I know how to be abound. I know how to be abased. He said, I will rejoice in my infirmity. I will rejoice in this affliction, because when I am at a place of weakness, that's when God's strength becomes perfect. Some of you, God wants to keep you low so his grace and his life can remain high. Some of you, God wants to keep you broken, that his power, his authority, his dominion upon your life will continue to increase and to expand. Many people will not understand this. Many people will think it's a warfare. Many people will think it's a spiritual warfare. Many people will think it's a demon. Many people will think you need deliverance. Many people will think you're not safe for real. You're hiding and doing things. That's why you're becoming sick. Many people won't have the grace to understand what you're going through. And so there's some things you will go through for the sake of God that many people will not understand, that you need not to share with everybody because they simply won't understand. I made a post a few minutes ago, but I felt led to do a video just to explain more thoroughly. He said, you are grace. I chose you to suffer this for my name's sake. It seems so unfair. And you know what the funny thing is? What many of you don't understand is, some of you see your prophets and your pastors and, you know, you celebrate them. You know, they're such a powerful man of God, a powerful woman of God, because you see the demonstration and the manifestation of God upon their lives. But what many of you do not see is the pain, the hardship, the struggle, the tears they have to go through behind the closed doors. What many leaders have to go through behind closed doors is the one thing or the few things that warrant them, that positions them to be used by God in the way that they're used by God. Not every prophet will go through this. There are some prophets, they'll pay their price, but not every prophet will go through certain things. Jeremiah was considered as the weeping prophet. You have lamentation. Every prophet walked a different journey. And so with saying all of this, 9:46, I'm finished. With saying all of this, whatever it is that you're going through, God has a plan and a purpose for your life. I want you to be encouraged that the suffering of this world, your light affliction, is only temporary. It's only temporal, and it cannot be compared to the weight of glory which shall be revealed when you get over to glory. I just want to encourage somebody today. Though you have prophesied to others and you haven't seen it come to pass in your life, though you have prayed in public and you seem like a powerful intercessor, you've prophesied, you're calling names, but when you get home and you go into the secret place, you can't even sometimes find the word to pray. You have to sit and you have to have conversations with God. This is where you have now come to a place of divine maturity, where it's not just about the prayers you praise, the conversations you begin to have. There are some people that lose their relationship, lose their prayer, lose their conversation, lose their conviction when it seems like God has given up on them, even though he hasn't. The Bible said that Mary and Martha cried. They said, how did you not come when we told you that Lazarus was going to die? And the Bible said that Jesus wept. Every time I feel like complaining to God, I remember Jesus wept. Every time I feel like a situation is getting bad, every time I feel like, why are you choosing me to suffer? Like, there's a recurring cycle. Every time you want to do something in my life, I have to pay the price and go through this. Every time I think about complaining, and it doesn't make it easier. To whom much is given, much is required. Though it seems like I may be mature and others may be mature, it doesn't make it any easier. We have emotions and we feel, we cry sometimes, we feel like giving up sometimes. Wasn't it Elijah? Where Elijah said that, I wish I would die. Job said, I curse the day I was born. Jonah wanted to run. There are so many prophets that wanted to give up. So many prophets wanted to give up. Every prophet has a story to tell. Every prophet has a journey and a path to take that is different. But I'm encouraging you today that if God be for you, who can be against you? You will not die before your time. God is going to see you through. And many may not understand, but run the good race. Run the good race. Stay the course. If God be God, and if you serve him with everything that you have, you may not see the rewards in this earth. Hear me by the Spirit of God. If you never see the reward while you're here on earth, there's a heavenly reward that you will receive. Your reward doesn't come from man. Your reward is not the house you will build, the dream house, the dream car. Your reward is not multiple thousands and hundreds of followers and subscribers on YouTube. It's not a mega church. So you may fail over and over. You may be rejected over and over. You may be a good person. Some of you are saying, I'm a good person, so I don't understand why I'm struggling, why people are treating me this way. I'm a good person because you were selected by God to go through. I won't go any further. I said I would make this a very short one. But be encouraged today. I know that the Lord is God, and that the Lord is good, and he's kind. God bless you.